floor of a light storage warehouse building is made of 15 centimeters thickness stone concrete. If the floor is a slab having a length of 3.5 meters and width of 3.0 meters, determine the resultant force caused by the dead load and the live load. Repeat again, we need to determine the resultant force caused by the dead load and the live load. First of all, we need to look at the picture at the left. We see the dimension of light storage stone concrete slab are 3.5 meters and 3 meter. And also the thickness is 15 centimeters. So, we can determine the problems easily. Look at the table 1.3 about minimum design dead loads. We see the stone concrete is 0.023 kilonewton per square meter. We multiply the minimum design dead loads of stone concrete with length, width and thickness of our slab. The answer of the dead loads of slab is 36.225 kilonewton. After that, we need to find the answer of the live loads of the slab. Look at the table 1.4 about minimum live loads. We see the lightweight storage warehouse is 6 kilonewton per square meter. We multiply the minimum live loads of lightweight storage warehouse with length and width of our slab. The answer of the live loads of slab is 63 kilonewton. After we know the dead loads and live loads, we can find the resultant force caused by the dead load and the live load is 99.225 kilonewton. Here is the way that we computed the resultant force caused by the dead load and the live load. Do you think this video helped you or not? If it is helpful, like, comment and share this video to your classmates. Thanks.